Hi, Philip Chesney here from Agile. For today's video, we're going to see how to write user stories. First, user stories are a short description of a small piece of business functionality that usually takes 1 to 3 days to complete. In many cases, teams will break down specific product features into more manageable, bite-sized pieces and put them on index cards, sticky notes, or into programs like Jira. Once we have these user stories written, they are added to the backlog and then prioritized as per the customer's needs. You will choose user stories that add the most value to the stakeholder, end user, or customer. Let's see how to write user stories. Start by writing down possible stories, otherwise known as candidate stories. We write these stories because we believe they will be part of building a particular feature. Let's imagine a feature, for example, taking a picture on the phone. Now, some of the candidate user stories could be create a Zoom function, add a video record option, add filters, etc. The team then needs to give an initial estimate on how long the stories will take. As we start our release planning, we can then go back and re-estimate the stories to give more detail. Number two, officially though, they're not user stories. To become user stories, they need to be written from the perspective of the customer and then written on the cards. Our user stories must reflect what the user desires and the language and the way he would describe it. You should have an idea of who your customers are and create a list of personas. See the video on how to use and write personas. Number three, look at the format we can follow. This isn't the only format, but it's the one that I'll present today. So letter A as A, and then we talk about the user or the role of the person. Then the next part, I want to, and then we talk about the functionality. And then letter C, so that we present the benefit here. So let's take a look at an example. As a lover of picture taking on my cell phone, I want to be able to zoom in with high resolution so that I can take great pictures of nature and animals. One valuable thing to remember is that when we write the stories, we need to be able to test them so we can know when they are finished. This is known as the acceptance criteria. The story is done and accepted by the customer, or it is declined. It is only one or the other. So we need to write our stories so we can test them accordingly. Here is another example. As a project manager, I want the website to offer a series of how-to videos so that when I have difficulty or want to review something, I can easily learn how to do it. There are multiple ways to keep track of your user stories. I have added a downloadable Excel option here. Other professionals may use Jira or other PM tools to keep track of their user stories. Just remember though, the best case scenario is if these stories can be visible. If you have wall space, put them up on the wall. This helps increase collaboration, promotes transparency, and others will know when there are new stories up on the board. Before we wrap up, let's look at one more user story to solidify the concept. As a user, I want to be able to log into the platform via Facebook so that I can access my account. Right below it, we also have our acceptance criteria. Account login can be done via Facebook for all user accounts. So there you have it. I hope that you've liked today's tip and will be able to put it into practice. Feel free to leave me any questions, comments, or share how you and your team normally write your user stories. And make sure to subscribe to the channel and share it with your team.